Dr. Vishal Pawar. I'm specialist neurologist at Astra Specialty Clinic, Discovery Gardens. In this video, I'm going to talk on hypertension and neurology. Hypertension is a very common disorder. It affects 10 to 12% of the world population. When it comes to neurology, there are certain implications as far as the hypertensive patients are concerned. So largely, blood pressure or hypertension is asymptomatic, that is, the patients don't have symptoms. But some patients can have headache and it gets better after taking the medications. So there are two types of implications on the nervous system. One is long-standing hypertension can cause some issues with the nervous system, and sudden rise of blood pressure can cause some issues. So coming to the long-standing hypertension, can lead to stroke. So stroke is nothing but formation of clots in the brain or bleeding in the brain. So it is second most common cause of death worldwide, and those who survive out of stroke, 50% of them are left with disability. So it's very important that this deadly complication can be prevented. So treating the hypertension can prevent 50% of the strokes. So it's very important to treat the hypertension. Then long-standing hypertension can lead to dementia, that is memory loss. Long-standing hypertension in diabetes can lead to nerve issues. So now coming to sudden rise of blood pressure, can lead to certain symptoms like severe headaches. It can lead to loss of, sometimes even loss of vision. It can cause loss of consciousness. It can cause fits. So it's very important to know about this. Then there are certain myths amongst the patient about high blood pressure. One is, will I get addicted to the medicine? Second is, I don't have any symptoms right now, should I take the medicine? So the medicines for blood pressure are given to control the blood pressure and to prevent the long-term complications. And it is not for the addiction, it is for to prevent the long-term complication. Even though you are not suffering from symptoms right now, it can lead to complications later on. Then another common myth we see is, I have a lot of fluctuations in blood pressure, I have low blood pressure problem. Those who have less than 120/80 millimeters of mercury blood pressure and absolutely conscious without any symptoms, that is optimal blood pressure and is not low blood pressure. And fluctuations are very common in blood pressure, that is with every beat of the heart the blood pressure keeps changing, and fluctuations are common with activity, with rest, with a lot of beverages like coffee, tea, smoking can elevate the blood pressure. So it's very important to get consultation and get treated for the blood pressure to avoid the long-term complications. Thank you so much.